with Cliffo and Gabby on Hit 103.1.
There it is. That is the brand new one for Samantha Jade. It's called Bounce. You probably saw it on AGT. It was on the, I think it was the grand final show a few weeks ago. But she's here to talk about it to us now. Samantha Jade, welcome back to Hit 103.1.
Hello. Thank you.
It's been a while, Sam. What have you been up to?
It has been a while. Well, I basically, the beginning of the year was like, I'm going to take some time to write and record and really get back into the process of just living in the studio. So I've just been locked away in studios, really.
I wanted to talk to you about that because I know some of the writing and recording process happened in the United States of America.
Yes.
And can we get the truth now? Is that just a junket? Is that, are you, can you just flex the muscle and go, look, guys, I'm going to write this album
in New York,
but I really need to be in the United States to do it.
Can you imagine? I can only record in Paris.
I wish.
No, I actually wanted to go to LA because I had worked with this girl, Carmen Reese, who wrote, I wrote Always With and Shake That With. And I kind of called her and said, do you have 2 weeks that you can just, you know, be with me and we'll go and work with different producers. But I wanted to make sure that the songwriting was consistent.
So good. Cool. We're on the air with Samantha Jade. Just heard that new single she's talking about, Bounce, it's called. Samantha, we are doing a thing here at Hit 103.1 at the moment that we wanted to run by you.
Oh, okay.
It's called Hit 103.1's Backseat Dating, where we're getting eligible singles.
Okay.
In Townsville. It's a bit like carpool karaoke.
But a lot more awkward.
But a lot more awkward. So we're putting them in the backseat of a car for a blind date.
Oh, wow.
And obviously, okay. I mean, you're an engaged woman now.
I am.
But could you offer, I mean, you were single not that long ago.
Yeah.
Can you offer any advice to our singles out there who want to have a crack at backseat dating? Like, have you been on blind dates before, that kind of thing?
I haven't, and I haven't been on a backseat blind date either. But my best friend went on a blind date, and she was beyond nervous about it, and she's still with the guy now.
So it can lead to success.
I just thought,
like, because I asked you there if you've been on a blind date before. I just thought, imagine that being a dude, you rock up for a blind date and it's Samantha Jade.
Oh.
I've seen you before somewhere.
He's like, oh my God, thank you, Lord.
No, do you know what I reckon, like, with dating? You've just got to be yourself. I think that is, and it's hard to be because you're, you know, nervous and there's probably a million things going through your mind, but just be you, because at the end of the day, people love genuine people. You know, that's what people connect to the most. So I reckon be yourself. Don't try to impress. Just be you.
Great advice. Hard to follow, but good advice.
It is hard to follow, but I reckon that's the kicker. And I think that my friend who went on the blind date that was very successful was like that. And she had been on heaps of dates and she hadn't found someone. And then she was like, I'm just going to try this and I'm just going to be me and just see how it goes. And it ended up being the one. Yeah.
Hey, while we're asking the tough questions.
Yes.
Can we ask you about these rumors that you are behind one of the masks on Channel 10's runaway hit, The Masked Singer? I thought I was dead set thinking you were the alien.
Oh, you thought the alien was Nikki Webster.
I thought you were the alien. It turned out being Nikki Webster.
Okay, everyone, like everyone, my family members, friends, I was getting text messages, I was being interviewed about it, and I was like, I hadn't seen it yet, and I was like, what is everyone going on about? And I think that the big thing that everyone thought was that we're both short.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh yeah, I can see that. But I thought she was so great on the show.
So good. Are you that flexible though? Because she did have her leg up by her ear.
100% not. And that's why I think that everyone who knows me should have known. That's definitely not her.
I'm not surprised that Nikki can do that, though, because she runs...
She's a great dancer.
Yeah, she runs a dance school now. She's a very established dance teacher.
Yeah, and she's so nice. I actually randomly met her husband on a plane years ago. And he was, a flight attendant, I'm sure. And he came up and he's like, oh, My wife, she's a singer too. And I was like, oh, yeah. He's like, Nikki Webster. And I was like, oh, my God, yeah. Anyone from Australia knows exactly who that is. Yeah, and he was so, so lovely. So
it's a compliment that you were mistaken for Nikki Webster.
I will take it. Yeah. I think she's great.
And I like that that's a roundabout way of talking about the Masked Singer without confirming that you're actually on the show.
Well,
you deflected very well there, Samantha.
She did say that everyone was confusing her because she'd never seen it, didn't know what they were talking about. So I'm going to say she's not on it.
All right.
She
ain't in a unicorn. There you go. Yep. All right. My daughter's going to be very upset, man. She's in love with that unicorn.
That unicorn is great.
Oh, so cute. hey, your new song, it's awesome. It's called Bounce. Get around at Townsville. And SamanthaJadeOfficial.com is the website if you want to check out what Samantha's been up to. But for now, thanks for your time, mate. Good luck with the single.
Thank you, guys. Get up with